over Moore Towers and Marinero. And here's another intriguing story here at the Nationals. 5 years ago, Luba was here winning Skate Canada. Loved Canada so much, who would have thought 5 years later she'd be with Dylan Moskovich, who she competed against, and what could be more appropriate, from Russia with love.
Building speed here into their side-by-side triple jumps.
Little shaky.
And it doesn't get easier. This is their most difficult element. Triple twist. Not bad. Now right into side-by-side triple salchows. They need these. No.
Touchdown.
Just a touchdown.
So the window, the cushion, of the point total, the lead they had, has just been extinguished.
And this is where the newness of a team comes into play when you're struggling. To rely on their experience to get them through. Throw triple Lutz.
Hang it on.
Beautiful connection between the two of them. Creating wonderful moments to this music.
The strongest male pair skaters on the planet.
Gonna need everything they've got here. Throw triple loop. Wow.
Needed that. Love this. Where they struggled yesterday on the side-by-side spins.
Final lift here.
Well, they'll get a standing ovation. They know there's work to be done. First time out at a Nationals for Russian-born skater Lubov Ilya Shishkina. They've become fan favorites already. The new MTM currently sitting in second place. They had a four-point lead.
Well,
let's see where that will stand.
They had some glitches at the beginning, but what impressed me was the way they were able to build and finish so strongly and bring this audience to its feet.
We'll get their marks, and then Megan and Eric skate for four in a moment. Megan DeHemmel, Eric Radford should make it four here in a moment. The drama, though, is for second and third, who will join them at the Worlds. Julianne Sagan and Charlie Bilodeau are currently the leaders.
So the opening jumps, the most important thing with the jumps, first of all, that you rotate, then that you stand on your feet. And they were able to do that, although Lubov got a little bit off. So the quality marks of that element will take it down about a point. They had some spectacular lifts. Look at this with Dylan on one knee. And then look at the speed here. Circling the ice, filling out the arena. Lubov holding a spectacular position. Dylan going to one foot and then continuing to spin. Those are the little details that are going to pick up qualities, as well as this. Not only will that pick up points for the quality the judges will appreciate, but it was the moment where the audience just went, wow, you've got me. And they went from fighting through the performance to totally bringing the performance home with conviction.
They need 116.29 for first place. 115.34 for second.
And so interesting, in the short program, they had a strong start and then lost it towards the end, the opposite here. Anxious moments for the skaters. Oh, backstage, what a good-looking group. Boy,
not,
oh boy.
Not only a good-looking group, but an extraordinary pairs field. When a year ago, or even mid-season here, a lot of people thought, what's going on with pairs, with the exception of Megan and Eric, thinking maybe this is a dry spell. Guess what? They were wrong.
Not at all. And when you see the quality of these teams in this final flight and what they've been able to do with the newness and the youngness of these teams, and there's a look at your judging panel.
And it's good. They're making it hard on these judges.
Well, they're awarding quality marks for every one of the elements.
Okay.
Also the component, the second scores. And that's what's going to come into play here to see.
Let's see if they get 116.29 or better. Yes, they will.
122.7.
Yes, they will.
Score of
187.85.
Lubov and Dylan.
Lubov and Dylan. New team. MTM. Go down to third right now.
Can be so proud, and you can see there.